Good day everybody, welcome back to HIMT's YouTube channel. Today in this video we are going to see the exit exam questions for refresher in fire prevention and firefighting, the RFPF. So let us move on to the questions. Question number one. The radiation is the transfer of heat through the physical movement of particles from hotter to colder zone. Option A, true. Option D, false. It is not true. It is false because radiation is transfer of heat by energy waves. Moving on to the next question. A class D fire would involve the burning of option A, diesel oil, option B, dunnage, option C, magnesium, option D, electrical insulation. It's not diesel oil, it's not option B, dunnage, it's not option D, electrical insulation. The correct answer is option C, magnesium, because according to NFPA classification, class D is fires involving combustible metals like magnesium, titanium, sodium, potassium, zirconium. So the correct answer here it is option C, magnesium. Moving on to the third question. Cooling is the method of firefighting by limitation of option A, molecular chain reaction, option B, temperature, option C, fuel, option D, air. It's not option A, molecular chain reaction, it is inhibition. And removal of fuel, it is starvation. Removal of air is smothering. So cooling is the method of firefighting by limitation of temperature. Question number four. Which one of the following extinguishers is suitable for a fire involving flammable liquids? Option A, carbon dioxide. Option B, powder extinguisher. Option C, foam extinguisher. Option D, none of the above. Option A is wrong. Option B is also not correct. Option D is also not correct. So here the correct answer is foam extinguisher. It is used on class B fires involving flammable liquids. Next question. Which of the following fuels has the lowest flash point? Option A, candle wax. Option B, kerosene. Option C, coal. Option D, diesel fuel. Option A is not correct as candle wax is having a flash point around 200 degrees Celsius. Option C, coal is also not correct because it is also having a flash point of more than 200 degrees Celsius. Diesel fuel, it is having flash point around 60 degrees Celsius, whereas kerosene, it has only around 38 degrees Celsius. So kerosene is the correct answer in these options. Moving on to the next question. Which ship shall be provided with international shore connection for supply of water as extinguishing agent? Option A, tankers. Option B, all ships of 500 gross tonnage and above. Option C, passenger ships carrying more than 500 persons. Option D, passenger ship of 1000 person and above. Here the correct answer would be all ships of 500 gross tonnage and above, because according to the SOLAS requirement under chapter 2 of 2 regulation 19 says that ships above 500 gross tonnage and upwards must have at least one international shore connection. Moving on to the next question. The basic fire theory says that a fire needs four main elements in order to start: heat, fuel, oxygen and dash. Option A, hydrogen sulfide. Option B, carbon dioxide. Option C, a chain reaction. Option D, benzene. Option A is not correct. Option B is also not correct. Option D is also not correct. The correct answer here is a chain reaction. The fire takes place when there is a molecular chain reaction between heat, fuel and oxygen. These are the four elements of fire tetrahedron. Moving on to the next question. Putting fire out by removing fuel is called inhibition. Option A, true. Option B, false. It is not correct because putting fire out by removing fuel, it is known as starvation. It is not inhibition. Inhibition is removal of the molecular chain reaction. Moving on to the next question. The letters A, B and C on the portable fire extinguisher represent what? Option A, how much chemical it holds. Option B, the first three letters of the extinguisher. Option C, types of fire on which it can be used. Option D, none of the above. Option A is not correct. Option B is not correct. Option D is also not correct. Here the correct answer, it is going to be types of fire on which it can be used. The letter indicates the types or classification of fire on which that particular extinguisher can be used. Moving on to the next question. Fire plan tells what actions to take in emergency situation by option A, the shore fireman, option B, the crew, option C, the paramedics, option D, none of the above. Option B is not correct. Option C is also not correct. Option D, none of the above. Also not correct. So here the correct answer is the shore fireman. The fire plan are stored in containers near gangway to help the shore firemen to get easy understanding of the ship's firefighting equipments, the various zones and locations. So here the correct answer is option A, the shore fireman. Question number 11. Minimum capacity of emergency fire pump to be. Option A, 20 cubic meter per hour. Option B, 25 cubic meter per hour. Option C, 40 cubic meter per hour. Option D, 50 cubic meter per hour. So option A, it is not correct. Option C is also not correct. Option D is also not correct. Okay, the correct answer is 25 cubic meter per hour, because according to SOLAS regulations, the minimum capacity of emergency fire pump should be 40% of the total capacity, and in any case not less than 25 cubic meter per hour. So the correct answer is option B, 25 cubic meter per hour. Moving on to the next question. Class K fire involves high fatty oils. Option A, true. Option B, false. It's not option B, false. The class K fire involves high fatty oils according to the classification of NFPA. It is classified as class K, and it is defined as fires involving combustible cooking media like vegetable oil or animal fats. Hence, the statement is true. Hazards in accommodation. Furnishings and personal effects, cigarette smoking, defective electrical connections, option D, all of the above. So all the mentioned points are correct. Hence, the correct answer here is all of the above. Next question. Fire patrol to be done on passenger vessels carrying more than 36 passengers. Option A, true. Option B, false. It is not false. The statement is true, because according to SOLAS, fire patrol has to be carried out on passenger vessels carrying more than 36 passengers so that an outbreak of fire may be promptly detected. The next question. Electricity switchboard fire with power on, what type of extinguisher to be used? Option A, DCB. Option B, water. Option C, foam. Option D, carbon dioxide. Option B and C, we can neglect it because they are conductors of electricity, they cannot be used. Option A, DCP, is also not correct because it will leave residues. So the correct answer is carbon dioxide. Okay, now we can have a 2 minutes break. During this break, I would like to introduce you to HIMT. At HIMT, we are conducting various post-C courses. Both DGS approved courses and UKMCA approved courses are available. We conduct the advanced, basic, simulator, revalidation, competency courses along with some value-added courses. The courses are available in our various institutions at PILPOC, WISAC and Tidal Park. Also, we do conduct the pre-C courses at HIMT Kalpakkam. We have the various streams like BSc Nautical Science for 3 years, the BTEC Marine Engineering for 4 years, the Graduate Marine Engineer course for the Mechanical Engineers, 1 year course, and we have the Bridging course for the Electrical Engineers, the Electrotechnical Officer course for 4 months, and we have the GP Writing course for 6 months, and also we conduct the Orientation course for the Catering Personals. For more details, you can visit our website at www.hmdcollege.com. And for the post-C courses, you can visit www.hmtmarine.com. Okay, now let's get back to our questions. Question number 16. Substances involving wood, plastic and paper are classified as option A, class A fire, option B, class B fire, option C, class C fire, option D, class D fire. Option A is the correct answer, because according to NFPA, again, it is classified as fires involving ordinary combustible materials such as wood, cloth, paper and plastics is class A fire. So the correct answer over here, it is class A fire. Moving on to the next question. Fire is the process of combustion accompanied by the rapid release of heat and dash. Option A, light. Option B, energy. Option C, destruction. Option D, none of the above. It's not option D. It's not option B. It is not also option C. The correct answer here is light. Both are the forms of energy. Moving on to the next question. On fires involving burning liquids, which of the extinguisher is considered most effective? Option A, water. Option B, foam. Option C, DCP. Option D, CO2. Option A is not correct. Option D is not correct. Option C is also not correct. The correct answer is option B, foam. Foam extinguisher is used on class B fires involving flammable liquids. Next question. Fire control plan on board ship is written in which language? Option A, English. Option B, Hindi. Option C, French. Option D, Spanish. It's not option D, Spanish. It's not option B, Hindi. It's not option C, French. The correct answer is English. The fire control plan is mandatory requirement of SOLAS convention and it has to be in English, which is understood by all. Next question. Portable extinguishers should not be more than 13 kg. Option A, true. Option B, false. It is not true. The correct answer is false. It is false because the regulation states that the portable extinguisher should not exceed 23 kgs in any case. It is not 13 kg, it is 23 kgs. Question number 21. Fire tends to start in a switchboard due to short circuit. This is which class fire? Option A, class A. Option B, class B. Option C, class C. Option D, class D. It's not option A. It's not option B. It's not option B. The correct answer is going to be class C. Because according to NFPA classification, class C are fires which involve energized electrical equipment. So the correct answer is class C fire. Moving on to the next question. Firefighters should come back from the area. Option A, after 10 minutes of firefighting. Option B, upon instruction from other firefighter. Option C, upon hearing the warning sound from SCBA. Option D, none of the above. No, it's not none of the above. It's not upon instruction from other firefighter. It's not after 10 minutes of firefighting also. The correct answer here is upon hearing the warning sound from SCBA. Question number 23. If restricted visibility encountered in an accommodation fire, you would option A, carry a torch. Option B, stand up straight to keep your head above smoke. Option C, use of a fan to blow the smoke and flames. Option D, rig lifelines to assist a retreat. Option A is not correct. Option B is also not correct. Option C is not correct. It's option D, rig lifelines to assist a retreat. The fireproof lifelines are used to assist in retreat while entering into smoke-filled compartments during the firefight. Question number 24. What is the important characteristic of extinguishing agent in fighting a class C fire? Option A, weight. Option B, temperature. Option C, electrical non-conductivity. Option D, cost. It's not option A, weight. It's not option B, temperature. It's not option B, cost. The correct answer is electrical non-conductivity. According to NFPA classification, the class C are fires which involves energized electrical equipment. So the extinguishing agents, they need to have the property of electrical non-conductivity to fight a fire. Moving on to the question number 25. Foam tends to extinguish fire by dash. Option A, chemically absorbing the oxygen. Option B, smothering the burning material. Option C, releasing large amount of CO2. Option D, none of the above. The correct answer over here, it is going to be smothering the burning material. Why? Because foam extinguishes fire by covering or blanketing the fire, thus cutting the oxygen supply. So if we cut the oxygen supply, we have learned it is smothering. So the correct answer is smothering the burning material. What is your first action on seeing fire? Option A, go to the muster station. Option B, extinguish the fire immediately. Option C, try on alarm and try to make on initial attempt to fight the fire. Option D, none of the above. It's not option A, it's not option B, it's not also option D. The correct answer is try on alarm and try to make on initial attempt. As the full form of fire stands, find, inform, respect, and exchange. Question number 27. Foam fixed firefighting system is used in which type of vessels? Option A, oil tanker. Option B, container ship. Option C, gas carriers. Option D, bulk carriers. It's not option B, it's not option C, it's not also option D. The foam fixed firefighting system is used in oil tankers. Question number 28. Full form of AFFF is aqueous film forming foam. Option A, true. Option B, false. It's not false, it's a correct statement. The AFFF stands for aqueous film forming foam. Question number 29. What is the color coding of portable DCP type extinguisher? Option A, black. Option B, yellow. Option C, blue. Option D, signal red. It's not option A, black. It is for CO2. It's not option B, yellow. It is for foam. It's not option D, signal red. It is for water. It's the correct answer is blue. DCP is having blue type color coding. The last question. Fire alarm is option A, continuous ringing. Option B, verbal order by the master. Option C, 7 short blasts followed by 1 long blast. Option D, none of the above. It's not option B. It's not option C also. It's not option D. The correct answer is the fire alarm is continuous ringing. Thank you for watching this video. Kindly subscribe to our channel if you haven't subscribed yet. Also press on the bell button by the side so that you get the latest update of our next video as soon as we post them. Thanks for watching once again. Bye.